video, top 7 foods that are actually good for you. Completely change the way you look at potassium.
I don't like it.
Catherine here, I've been helping people more than 10 years now. I've seen people succeeding in what many consider impossible, having stable improvements in GFR and other markers such as creatinine. And there is one diet that always seems to give the best results. A diet rich in potassium.
Wait, what?
And I can prove that what I'm saying is true. There is a large study focused on stopping and reversing the through the diet. This study saw stage 4 patients completely stopping the progression of all thanks to a more alkaline diet. And you know what's the most alkaline thing you can have in your diet? It's potassium.
Wow, that's amazing.
So it should be of no surprise that they were instructed to eat high potassium foods such as potatoes, Brussels sprouts, kale, and broccoli on a daily basis. And yet today, if you search info online about potassium, most websites will still provide you with outdated, mostly wrong information. The Vita website is an example. Now, the Vita is, and they are supposed to be an authority. And yet, if you search for how to prevent potassium levels from getting too high, on their website, one of the first answers is still limit foods that are high in potassium. Which is completely wrong, by the way. I'll show you why later on in this video. So today we will see the bright side of this whole mess. Let's start with the top 7 of foods you were told to avoid but that are actually very good for you. Number 7, red potatoes. Okay, potatoes are amazing. It's a shame that people were forbidden to eat them for so long. I mean, who doesn't love potatoes? And they are also healthy for you. Besides their potassium content, potatoes are a gluten-free carb sources that's low enough on the GI scale if cooked them in the right way. Potatoes are as rich in nutrients and fiber as many other veggies. So question, why you want potatoes in your diet? Well, besides the simple fact that they taste so good, potatoes are a great source of resistant starch. This starch is not broken down and fully absorbed by the body. Research has linked resistant starch to many health benefits, including reducing insulin resistance, which in turn improves sugar control. Potatoes with the highest resistant starch content and the lower glycemic index are red potatoes. Interestingly, you can also increase the resistant starch content of potatoes. To do this, store boiled potatoes in the fridge overnight and consume them cold. This will actually lower their GI even more. Many more healthy foods to come. A very important question before that. Why is potassium so good for you? Potassium is one of the most important micronutrients in human nutrition. It's needed for so many bodily functions, and most people consume way less than they need. Potassium-rich diets can help to, according to science. Higher potassium intake is linked to less metabolic acidosis, less inflammation, less fibrosis or scarring, less risk for heart problems. It even protects the bones. So these are benefits that all the foods of today's video are going to have. Plus, these foods also come with their own benefits. Yup, once you will finish watching today's video, your mind will be blown by all the health benefits you are losing due to poor dietary advice. Next food, our number 6. Okay, here's the fruit that has been the symbol of potassium itself for so long. Number 6, bananas. Many people think about bananas when potassium is mentioned. But what if I tell you that latest studies are showing that we are only going to get a fraction of the potassium from bananas we thought we could get? Anyways, there is more in bananas than potassium, and of various antioxidants and phytonutrients. And what if you have diabetes? Well, eat bananas unripe. A high proportion of the starch in unripe bananas is resistant starch, which passes through your gut undigested. Unripe bananas have a GI as low as 42. This starch turns into sugar when the banana becomes ripe. So the greener the banana, the less sugar in it. But as always, moderation is key with fruit. And you will still be getting some potassium, which is very good, as we have seen. Question: is there any proof that dietary potassium is not actually dangerous? Now, potassium ended up on the list of things to avoid in a rather unscientific way. There was no reasoning behind it. They just thought that since potassium was too high, restricting potassium intake was the way to go. But just like it happens for cholesterol, there is a very small direct correlation between the amount of a certain substance we get in the diet and the amount we have. So we know today that just a small part actually needs to restrict potassium, and also that restricting potassium is not really going to help lowering blood potassium levels. Now, there are also cases in which a patient has his blood potassium too high already, that a diet rich in potassium may actually cause problems. So take a look at your last blood analysis and see how high is your blood potassium. Chances are your potassium are not too high, but if that happens and you have more than 5.2 milliequivalents per liter of blood potassium, well, you will need to take care of that, and avoiding high potassium foods is not gonna help. We will see what to do in a moment. Before, another high potassium fruit is a favorite of dieters around the world, and it comes with many health benefits. Number 5, avocado. Avocados truly are vitamin powerhouses. They are rich in vitamin C, E, K, and B6, as well as riboflavin, niacin, folate, pantothenic acid, and magnesium.
Wow!
Yeah, these nutrients are key for good kidney health. Avocados are so rich in antioxidant and anti-inflammatory compounds, they can protect your heart and kidneys from oxidative damage, which is associated with the progression of chronic diseases. And they are so rich in potassium. But the reason that makes them so good for you is another. So why should you add avocados to your diet? While most fruits mostly contain carbs, avocados are richer in healthy fats than carbs. This makes them the best friends of your kidneys and of your heart. Researchers have found that avocados may protect the heart in a similar way as olive oil and nuts do in the Mediterranean diet. Besides, avocados won't spike your blood sugar levels like other fruits do, and they may be a useful tool for weight loss. Avocados help promote satiety thanks to their high fiber and healthy fat content. And that's why a number of studies have associated avocado intake with weight loss, improved satiety, and decreased abdominal fat. Now, a very important question: what to do if your potassium levels are actually too high? According to statistics, 1 out of 5 CKD patients has too high potassium levels. And while it's too easy from a doctor's perspective to blame it on dietary potassium, that's not going to help the patient at all. High potassium levels are mostly caused by factors not related to the diet. So why do certain patients have too high potassium levels if it's not the foods? Here's the answer, directly from current guidelines for CKD management. So, to be clear, this says that if you have too high potassium levels, your doctor should check if you are constipated, if you are taking enough insulin, if diabetic, if you are doing dialysis often enough, if in dialysis, if you have metabolic acidosis, and if you are taking certain medications, especially ARBs and ACE inhibitors. Solving these issues is almost always guaranteed to lower your blood potassium levels. This in turn will let you enjoy a diet higher in potassium and all the health benefits that it brings. And speaking of foods that you can really enjoy, let's see an antioxidant superstar with a delicious taste. Number 4, cantaloupe. Cantaloupe makes a refreshing snack in the summer, but this delicious treat is actually available year-round. This fruit packs loads of potassium and other minerals, but also vitamins and antioxidants. Oxidative stress is one of the main processes that damage the kidneys, and a diet rich in antioxidants can really help. Now, there is a reason why CKD patients may want to include cantaloupe in their diet. Inositol, also known as vitamin B8, inositol is a key nutrient for those with diabetes. In the body, it has an effect similar to that of metformin, but it's completely natural. There are studies that link supplementing this vitamin to a fast improvement in glucose levels and A1C levels in diabetes patients. Now, cantaloupes are available year-round, although they may be more expensive during the winter months. But hey, if I didn't knew till yesterday that I could eat cantaloupes, I would go buy a couple even in January. Just remember that cantaloupes are very sweet, so to maximize the health benefits, moderation is key. Okay, up next, a fruit that directly helps the kidneys. Studies have shown that the oil of this fruit can be of help in case of kidney problems. Number 3, coconut. Coconuts, just like avocados, are richer in fats than carbs, which is great especially for people with diabetes. It means these fruits are a source of energy that won't spike your blood sugar. Now, much of the fat in coconut is in the form of medium chain triglycerides, MCTs. This is the only form of fat that the body can use as an immediate source of energy, a bit like carbs. So eating coconuts will make you feel more energized, but without causing problems for those with diabetes. MCTs are so healthy for the kidneys, especially in case of diabetes, that you can also get them in oil form to supplement your diet. Studies say they may improve insulin resistance and help overweight people lose weight. And you can also get these healthy fats from coconuts. Now, like with the other fruits of this video, moderation is key when consuming coconuts since they are very caloric. Our top 2 now, some of the healthiest veggies you didn't know you could eat. Number 2, broccoli. Broccoli is definitely one of the healthiest foods on earth, a true powerhouse of nutrients. It's reputed to benefit digestion, the cardiovascular system, and the immune system, and to have anti-inflammatory and even cancer-preventing properties. It also has detoxing properties, very useful to lower your creatinine levels and improve the health of your kidneys thanks to unique phytochemicals. These plant compounds aid all steps of the body's detoxification process, from activation to neutralization and elimination of contaminants. Incredible benefits for sure, you don't want to miss out. Just make sure not to overcook broccoli so you don't end up losing some precious nutrient. According to a recent study on cruciferous vegetables, the best way of cooking these superfoods is sauteing for up to 5 minutes, steaming for up to 20 minutes, or microwaving. Boiling, on the other hand, will remove lots of essential nutrients and health benefits. Okay, what can be even healthier than broccoli? Our number 1, the most alkaline veggie in the world, also known for its blood pressure lowering properties. Number 1 is spinach. Now, spinach is so healthy that I recommended it many times here, despite its very high potassium content. And now that we know that potassium is one more reason to want spinach in your diet, you can finally enjoy the alkaline and kidney restoring properties this veggie has to offer. Because following an alkaline diet really is a must for people with kidney disease. And if you want to know more about the most alkaline foods to add to your diet, this video up here is for you. And this is all for today. Thank you for watching. God bless.